Let us understand the meaning of macroeconomics. Macroeconomics is the branch of economics that studies the economic behavior of all the economic agents in the economy. It is a study of the economy as a whole. In other words, the macroeconomics is a study of the aggregate outcomes of the decisions undertaken by the different agents in the economy. To begin with the study of basic macroeconomics, let us introduce the concept of circular flows of income. The circular flows of income forms the basis of all macroeconomic models of the economy, and it is imperative to understand the circular flows of income for understanding the essential concepts such as national income, aggregate demand, aggregate supply, and so on. The circular flows of income describes the movement of goods and services in the economy amongst different sectors of the economy. It illustrates the interdependence of the sectors, the markets, and the different economic agents to facilitate both the real economy and the nominal economy or the monetary flows in the economy. The real flows refer to the flows of the factor services and the flows of goods and services produced. The flow of factor services from the households go to the firms, and the flow of goods and services go from the firms to the households. Both are real flows. The flow of factor services generates money incomes which go in the form of factor payments from the firms paid to the households. And similarly, the households need to pay the firms for the goods and services that they purchase from the firm sector. The movement of money or cash payments from one sector to the other is exactly matching the flow, the real flows which go from one sector of the economy to the other. It is a reverse flow in the sense that every real flow that goes from the households to the firms, let us say in the form of factor payments, has to be matched with a monetary flow in the form of wages and other kinds of remuneration for the factor services which are being provided by the households to the firms. Similarly, the real flow of goods and services which come from the firm sector to the household sector has to be matched by a flow in nominal or monetary terms, in terms of the price or the value of the goods and services which are being offered by the firm sector to the household sector. Therefore, the household's expenditure is something which goes in the form of monetary flows, and in return they get the real goods and services. Therefore, it is evident that both the real flows as well as the nominal flows, the expenditure as well as the income along with the factor services and the goods and services, all are circulating in the economy, and there is a complex two-way movement in terms of the two opposite directions in the economy, and this continuous flow of production, income and expenditure is known as the circular flows of income, or sometimes the circular flows of money. Of course, the circular flows of income is a better representation than the circular flows of money, because the main function of an economy is to produce goods and services, which is the same thing as saying the production of national income. If we look at it from the point of view of factor incomes, then it is national income. If we look at it from the point of view of gross national product of GNP, it is goods and services.
After studying this module, you shall be able to know the four macroeconomic sectors and the three markets, learn the interdependence between them, identify the different models of the circular flow of income, evaluate the injections and leakages in the circular flow, and analyze the circular flow of income. In order to understand the circular flow of income, it is imperative for us to first know the four macroeconomic sectors in the circular flow of income. The first sector is household sector. This sector includes all the individuals in the economy. The primary function of this sector is to provide the factors of production. The factors of production include land, labor, capital, and enterprise. The household sector are the consumers who consume the goods and services produced by the firms and in return make payments for the same. The households spend their income on 1. Payment for goods and services purchased from firms, 2. Tax payments to the government, and 3. Payments for imports. Second, the firms sector. This sector includes all the business entities, corporations, and partnerships. The primary function of this sector is to produce goods and services for sale in the market and make factor payments to the household sector. The firm makes payments for 1. Factor services to households, 2. Taxes to the government, and 3. Imports to the foreign sector. The third sector is the government sector. This sector includes the center, state, and local governments. The prime function of this sector is to regulate the functioning of the economy. The government sector incurs both revenue as well as expenditure. The government earns revenue from tax and non-tax sources and incurs expenditure to provide essential public services to the people. The fourth is the foreign sector. The foreign sector includes transactions with the rest of the world. Foreign trade implies net exports, exports minus imports. Exports include goods and services produced domestically and sold to the rest of the world. And imports include goods and services produced abroad and sold domestically. Foreign sector receives revenue from firms, households, and the government for export of goods and services. It makes payments for import of goods and services from firms and the government. It also makes payments for the factor services to the households. Let us now discuss the three markets. The first, the goods market. In this market, the goods and services are exchanged among the four macroeconomic sectors. The consumers are the household, government, and the foreign sector, while the producers are the firms sector. Second is the factor market, a marketplace for the services of a factor of production. A factor market facilitates the purchase and sale of services of factors of production which are inputs like labor, capital, land, and raw materials that are used by a firm to make a finished product. A factor market is distinct from the goods and services market, which is the market for finished products or services. The factors of production are traded through this market. For the production of final goods and services, the firms obtain the factor services and make payments in the form of rent, wages, and profits for the services to the household sector. Let us now discuss the third market, the financial market. Financial markets are typically defined by having transparent pricing, basic regulations on trading, costs and fees, and market forces determining the prices of securities that trade. Some financial markets only allow participants that meet certain criteria, which can be based on factors like the amount of money held, the investor's geographical location, knowledge of the markets, or the profession of the participant. This market consists of financial institutions such as banks and non-bank intermediaries who engage in borrowing, savings from households, and lending of money. Let us discuss the circular flow of income in a two-sector model. In this model, the economy is assumed to be a closed economy and consists of only two sectors, that is, the household and the firms. A closed economy is an economy that does not participate in international trade. In this model, the household sector is the only buyer of the goods and services produced by the firms, and it is also the only supplier of the factors of production. The household sector spends the entire income on the purchase of goods and services produced by the firms, implying that there is no saving or investment in the economy. The firms are the only producer of the goods and services. The firms generate income by selling the goods and services to the household sector, and the latter earns income by selling the factors of production to the former. Thus, the income of the producers is equal to the income of the households, is equal to the consumption expenditure of the household. The demand of the economy is equal to the supply. In this model, Y is equal to C, where Y is income and C is consumption. Now let us understand the circular flow of income in a two-sector model with saving and investment. We assume that the household sector spends its entire income and that there is no saving in the economy. However, in practice, the household sector does not spend all its income. It saves a part of it. The saving by the household sector would imply monetary withdrawal equal to saving from the circular flow of income. This would affect the sale of the firms, since the entire income of the household would not reach the firm, implying that the production of goods and services would be more than the sale. Consequently, the firms would decrease their production, which would lead to a fall in the income of the household, and so on. There is one way of equating the sales of the firms with the income generated. If the saving of the household is credited to the firms for investment, then the income gap could be filled. If the total investment I of the firms is equal to the total saving S of the household sector, then the equilibrium level of the economy would be maintained at the original level. The equilibrium condition for a two-sector model with saving and investment is as follows. y equal to c plus s or y equal to c plus I or c plus s equals to c plus I or s plus I, where y is equal to income, c is equal to consumption, s is equal to saving, and I is equal to investment. Let us now move on to discuss the circular flow of income in a three-sector model. The three-sector model of circulate flow of income highlights the role played by the government sector. This is a more realistic model which includes the economic activities of the government. However, we continue to assume the economy to be a closed one. There are no transactions with the rest of the world. The government levies taxes on the households and the firms, and it also gives subsidies to the firms and transfer payments to the household sector. Thus, there is income flow from the household and firms to the government via taxes in one direction, and there is income outflow from the government to the household and firms in the other direction. If the government revenue falls short of its expenditure, it is also known to borrow through financial markets. This sector adds three key elements to the circular flow model, that is, taxes, government purchases, and government borrowings. In circular flow of income, in a three-sector model, the equilibrium condition is as follows. Y equals C plus I plus G, where Y is equal to income, C is equal to consumption, I is equal to investment, and G is equal to government expenditure. In a closed economy, aggregate demand is measured by adding consumption, investment, and government expenditure. Thus, aggregate demand is defined as the total demand for final goods and services in an economy at a given time, and price level and aggregate supply is defined as the total supply of goods and services that the firms are willing to sell in an economy at a given price level. Next, we will discuss the circular flow of income in a four-sector model. This is the complete model of the circular flow of income that incorporates all the four macroeconomic sectors. Along with the above three sectors, it considers the effect of foreign trade on the circular flow. With the inclusion of this sector, the economy now becomes an open economy. Foreign trade includes two transactions, that is, exports and imports. Goods and services are exported from one country to the other countries, and imports come to a country from different countries in the goods market. There is a flow of income to the firms and government in the form of payments for the exports, and there is an outflow of income when the firms and the governments make payments abroad for the imports. The import payments and export receipt transactions are done in the financial market. Now we will discuss the leakages and injections in the circular flow of income. The flow of income in the circular flow model does not always remain constant. The volume of income flow decreases due to the leakages of income in the circular flow, and similarly, it increases with the injections of income into the circular flow. Leakages. A leakage is referred to as an outflow of income from the circular flow model. Leakages are that part of the income which the household withdraws from the circular flow and is not used to purchase goods and services. This part of the income does not go to the goods market. Three main leakages are savings, taxes, and imports. Let us discuss the three leakages in detail. First, saving. It is that part of the income that is not used by the household to purchase goods and services or pay taxes. It is kept with the financial institutions like banks that can be lent further by the banks to the firms for investment or capital expansion purposes. Second, taxes. Tax revenue is the income paid by the household and firms to the government. It flows to the government rather than to the goods market. Third, imports. Import payments are made to the foreign sector for the goods and services bought from them. This is an outflow of income from the economy. Imports leak out of the economy because the money in our country that is used to buy imports from other countries goes out of our economy and into their hands. Thus, we see that leakages reduce the volume of income from the circular flow of income. Leakages equals to S plus T plus M, where S is equal to saving, T is equal to taxes, and M is equal to imports. Injections. An injection is an inflow of income to the circular flow. The volume of income increases due to an injection of income in the circular flow. There are three main injections, and these are investment. It is the total expenditure by the firms on capital expansion. It flows to the goods market. Government expenditure. It is the total expenditure of the government on goods and services, subsidies to the firms, and transfer payments to the household sector. Transfer payments are government payments like social security schemes, pensions, retirement benefits, and temporary aid to needy families, etc. Exports. Export receipts are the payments made by the foreign sector for the purchase of domestic goods. It is an inflow of income from the foreign sector to the financial market. Injections is equal to I plus G plus X, where I is equal to investment, G is equal to government expenditure, and X is equal to exports. Balance of leakages and injections in an open economy is S plus T plus M equals to I plus G plus X, or S minus I equals to G minus T plus X minus M.
Now let us summarize what we have studied in the module. Circular flows of income describes the movement of goods and services and income amongst different sectors of the economy. It illustrates the interdependence of the sectors and the markets to facilitate both the real economy and the corresponding monetary flows. The real flow refers to the flow of factor services and the flow of goods and services produced by the firm sector. The movement of the money or cash payments from one sector to the other sector corresponding to this real flow refers to the monetary flow. There are four sectors and three markets in the circular flow of income model. The four sectors are the household sector, the firm sector, the government sector, and the foreign sector. The three markets are the goods market, the factors market, and the financial markets respectively. The circular flows of income can be analyzed with the help of three different models: circular flows of income in a two-sector economy, a three-sector economy, and a four-sector economy. In a two-sector model, the simplest model is one of the circular flow of income, and it assumes that the economy is a closed economy. There are only two sectors, the household sector and the firm sector. The flow of incomes and expenditure is between these sectors alone. In a three sector model, apart from these two sectors, there is another sector known as the government sector. The government sector is still operative in a closed economy, and there are still no transactions with the rest of the world. In a four sector model, this is a complete model of circular flows of income. It considers the effect of the foreign sector, which includes transactions with the rest of the world in the form of imports and exports, both of goods and services, as well as capital, which is in the form of capital flows or investment. Now, under these circumstances, the four sector model is known as an open economy model. The volume of income in the circular flows increases with the injections into the economy, and it decreases with the leakages in the economy. Injections are the inflows of the income in the circular flows, and leakages are outflows from the income stream in the circular flows. Injections are mainly private investment, government expenditure, and exports, while the leakages are savings, taxes, and imports.